Parkers? All right. Okay. We're going to put Manu Ginobili, right? You look left-handed, don't you? Okay, we're going to put Ginobili down here. Oh, there we go. You're a three-man. Okay. All right, we're going to put you over here on this wing, over here. Okay, two man starts on the baseline over here. So this is an example here when we're designing an inbounds play that we want to use the personnel we have. Now, Parker's a great player, but in this case, last possession, I want the ball in Ginobili's hands. He's a great penetrator. He can score and create. So you got a guy, maybe a two-man or a three-man. And one of the things I'll say about late game or inbound situations is that change your personnel. Maybe your two or three-man is not your best player. Maybe it's your four. So you can run a play like this, just change the numbers around. Make it to suit your personnel. Say, we got a basketball here? Somewhere? The one thing they didn't tell us. Okay. Thanks. So we're going to start here with Tony Parker here. All right. Again, this is about utilizing your personnel. So we're going to pass to Duncan. All right. He's going to slash through. Just go to the basket. Go to the corner. All right. And Ginobili's going to come up the top. Okay. He's going to isolate his man right up here. Just swing right up here. Okay. Now he's going to run a couple different sets out of this. All right. So we want him to have the ball. Why? Because Ginobili's a heck of a penetrator, right? Left hand, puts his head down, hard to stop. Okay, we're going to run, this is Duncan now, a pretty good one-on-one player, so you got to play him honest. Four man's going to set a pick right here, going to run a high post pick and roll. Here's our left-handed player who's one of the best finishers in the NBA. He's going to the basket, penetration, right? Three man, Jefferson flares to the corner. Got the other guy, Tony Parker, good shooter, good penetrator. He might slip, but normally if he sees Ginobili has a step, he's going to let him go. And you'll pop, right? Okay? So, maybe pick and pop. Maybe he gets hung up or strung out by the screen. Maybe you do slip. Maybe, you know, he cheats. Maybe you slip the basket. So, this is a situation where they've isolated Ginobili up top. Okay, come back here now. Same play. Go back down. Okay, another variation. He passes to Duncan here. Okay, another. Go on through. Ginobili comes up. So, last, 10 seconds of the game, they don't want Ginobili to have the ball, right? So they're going to deny him here. Okay, what we're going to do in that situation, we're going to back screen him, right? Okay, we got a mismatch. We're going to talk about that in a minute. Mismatch screen right here. Ginobili cuts to the basket. Got a back cut to the basket. This player here, he can pop, or maybe they get a switch. We get a mismatch here. We got a small penetrator against the center. Maybe the center comes over to help. Duncan dives the basket. Creates a tough situation to defend, okay? All right. Let's look at another situation that utilizes personnel. Houston Rockets run this play. All right, let's put point guard up here again.